Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We're at MTK Manchester today. We've got the English light heavyweight champion, Liam Conroy, with us. How you doing, Liam?
I'm all right, mate. How are you?
Good. Yeah, good to see you. And I was just saying to you then off camera that 2018 could be a really big year for you, couldn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Wanting to make big moves this year, get some decent titles and get in amongst the top of the British rankings, really.
Yeah, I mean, your story, it's a real success story, because at the beginning of your career you did have some ups and downs.
Yeah.
Particularly, I remember watching you in the Prize Fighter, and you know, but since then you've gone on this unbeaten streak of 11 fights, and where have you found this new sort of confidence in the ring from?
I don't know, really. I think I just learned a lot from Prize Fighter and learned a lot from the bad fights I've had, and I just stayed in the gym and stuck with it. Me and Johnny have just worked together and a few things that obviously I found my weight, because I was boxing at middleweight then, and since I've been boxing at like heavyweight, I just felt like loads stronger and loads better, and just learning and enjoying it more, really. Just relax and enjoy it, and it's just coming together.
Yeah, I mean, you're quite young. I mean, you're still young now, but you were quite young when you had the loss in the Prize Fighter, weren't you? I think you were only 22, weren't you?
Yeah, 22, and only had like 8 fights, so yeah. But I'm glad it happened, really, because it's eye-opening experience. It's got me where I am, really, so.
Yeah, it takes a lot of mental strength as well to come back from various setbacks, but you've shown that real mental strength. Where do you sort of get that from?
I don't know, really. I was down with it, and I was thinking I was knocking on the head, and Johnny, all to Johnny, really, he just sat me down and said, look, you are talented, you've got titles in you, and I don't want you to stop until you've got one, and I just believed in Johnny and started enjoying it. He convinced me to move up to like heavy, so I owe all to Johnny, his belief in me, and he stuck with me through the downs. It would have been easy to just let me walk away, but he just kept me involved and built me back up to where I am now.
Yeah, well, it's work, because you are the English champion at the minute, and I was just looking at the lightweight rankings in Britain the other day, and they're pretty good, aren't they? I mean, there's great fights either side of where you are at the minute, aren't they?
Yeah, definitely. The division's wide open, like I was saying before. So I think most of them top 10 could beat each other on a given day. Even the top 15 and some top quality lads, and top quality lads up and around the northwest itself.
Yeah.
So there's some good fights to be made in the future.
Now, I know you're keen for a British title shot at some point, aren't you?
Yeah, definitely.
In the near future. I mean, you know, Frank Bugley only is the champ at the minute, and then you've got Jose Burton and Anthony Yard at the top three at the minute.
Yeah.
I mean, given those three opponents, would that be your pick then, the Frank Buglioni fight?
For a British title, yeah. That's the goal, that. So that's what I wanted to achieve when I turned professional. Never quite knew. Never really thought I'd ever get near, really, but I'm pretty close now, and I think that I'm capable of winning a British title. So whenever my team wants me to go for it and decides I'm ready, and that's what's next, that's what we'll do.
Yeah.
Confident we'll do it.
And of course, having a title makes you sort of chased as well. There's these guys that are just beneath you in the rankings, and they're probably going to be looking at you and chasing you as well. I mean, are you aware of some of the other lads' names that are you know, below you in the rankings that might be looking for your title?
Yeah, quality lads. Always blowing up my Twitter and stuff. Miles Shinquin mentions me a lot, and there's Jake Ball, and there's a few lads that obviously want what I've got, so it's just up for me to stay on top of my game and make sure that they can't take what I've worked so hard to get.
Would you be interested in defending again then, or are you more interested in moving on? What's your sort of mind frame?
To me, it just depends on circumstances, like what Johnny wants for the plan next. So next time I might defend, or we might go for another title, some type of international title or something. I'm not sure yet, but it just depends on the circumstances and what Johnny thinks is best, really. I've got no reason to go against anything Johnny says. Everything he's said since Prize Fighter has worked, and I'll just carry on following his plan.
Yeah, I mean, in your last fight, I think you stopped, was it Hobbs, was it you fought? Yeah, and you stopped him in the 9th round, was it?
Yeah.
I mean, that shows as well that you've got an engine on you as well, you know, they move up to 10 round fights as
yeah.
well.
So I've, out of my last 4, I've stopped them all, 2 of them being in the 9th and 2 of them being in the 2nd, so I can take you out early, or I'd like to think I've got the strength later on in a fight as well, so.
Yeah.
And building these 10 rounders now, getting used to them, so enjoying it.
Yeah, exactly. And obviously, work under the banner of MTK as well, with a massive banner. Yeah. That must be good as well, to be part of this really growing team and stable.
Yeah, it's just like top fighters they've got on the books now. I'm just like buzzing to be part of it, you know what I mean? But since MTK have been part of this team and been involved in this gym, it's just come on leaps and bounds, and that's another thing I've got to be thankful for the success, because without MTK, it wouldn't have been nowhere near as easy the route as we've had.
Yeah. Well, listen, it's 2018. It's all for you out there. It's the world's your oyster, as they say, and I'm sure some big fights are coming your way soon.
Yeah.
Been good catching up with you. Anything you just want to say on a final note?
No, just thanks to everyone that comes to watch me every time. I have a close-knit team that come down every time, and I get good support from Barra, so I just want to thank everyone that comes down.
Brilliant. Well, listen, Liam, wish you all the very best for the new year and 2018. Big year for the light heavyweight division. Yeah. Aki Kareem, British boxers, you know the score. Power.